Hi again, this is Greg Hughes from .com Classroom. Well, if you haven't heard of artificial intelligence or AI, then you have probably been on another planet somewhere the last 12 months because it's absolutely the talk of the internet. With the advent of artificial intelligence over the course of the year, especially in 2022, things have changed online so significantly that it's just about every YouTube video you can watch is about AI. Every blog post is about AI, how to use it in creating content for your blogs and your websites and your marketing materials and your research. And all of that's exciting and wonderful. Like we're on the precipice of something new and great. And in November of 22, which is just a couple of months before this recording, the OpenAI, of course, introduced ChatGPT and they released it to the public. And everybody got excited. Millions of people have jumped on board. And you can go in there and I'm sure you've heard this. You can type a prompt and it will create content for you, write blog posts and essays, ebooks if you want. Can be created now with artificial intelligence. You've probably heard all of that. And maybe you've even gone to ChatGPT through the OpenAI.com website, or maybe you've used the DALL-E 2 image generator, an unbelievable artificial intelligence creating art from nothing, seemingly. Pretty exciting stuff. There's just one problem with this whole AI thing, and that is Google hates it. I'll show you what I mean. Search Engine Journal saying that Google AI-generated content is against guidelines. Search Engine Lands reporting that content created primarily for search engine rankings, however it's done, is against our guidance. What about Google AdSense? Websites with AI-generated content not eligible for AdSense. What is going on? Everybody wants to use artificial intelligence, and I don't blame them, and I do too. But the problem is when the technology that's used to generate content is implemented, unfortunately, it's not human enough and it can be detected by Google's algorithm. So that can be a problem. But of course, for every problem, there's a solution. And I'm going to show you that solution in this video. So you may have gone to ChatGPT and created some content. Maybe you've played with it. One of the problems with it right now is it is so busy, it's actually hard to get in. I'm recording this in January of 23, and although I've done a lot of work in ChatGPT for the last 3 days, I haven't even been able to get in because so many people are using AI. But fortunately, there are a lot of other programs using the same technology. There's a lot of artificial intelligent content creators. Probably the most famous one right now is Jasper, and that's a good one to look into. Check it out if you want to. I'm going to show you the one that I like. It's called Writer. R-Y-T-R.me is the domain. It's a great tool. What I love about it is it works good. I've created several pieces of content with it. And it's really inexpensive. Very fair pricing. Probably going to be dozens or hundreds more as time goes on. Because we're just at the infancy of this whole thing. But I like this one. I'm going to be showing you how to use artificial intelligence to create content, specifically a blog post, and then how to humanize it. It's much simpler than you may think. I went into my Writer account and I created a real simple couple of paragraphs. I just had Writer artificially generate a section of a blog post for me. Okay, this is what the interface looks like here. It's really great interface too, because I can choose the tone I want it to be written in. I usually use convincing at this point, but there's all kinds of things you can use. And I just typed out the name of the topic. I wanted to write a couple of paragraphs on how to do keyword research for my blog. I gave it some keywords that it can use in this little snippet. And I can ask for how many variants I want. I'll just choose one. And I want the creativity level to be optimal. So that's just the way Writer works. Not all of them have these settings, but that's the way Writer works. I click the button and this is what it generated. So this is a very sensible couple of paragraphs on the topic of doing keyword research for blogging and for search engine optimization. Makes perfect sense. And you might think you can just take this, copy it, and paste it right into your blog or wherever you want. But if you do, Google's not going to like it for all the reasons we just talked about. Google wants human written content, and I'm glad it does. We don't all want to end up just reading robotic content for the rest of our lives on the internet. And so this is a good thing. But let me show you how to make this human. First of all, we need to see how Google's going to see it. And so you actually need to use another piece of software that can detect content that has been written artificially. Now, the most popular one is this one called originality.ai, and it's great. It does a lot of really cool things. But again, I'm looking at pricing, and while it doesn't seem too expensive, and I'm sure a lot of people are going to be using this, you know, it's only 1 cent per credit, and a credit allows you to scan 100 words. That's all great stuff. Probably a good one to use. I found another way to do it. So I found an AI content detector that's free, at least for now. And it's really a great website. And so while I'm using Writer, R-Y-T-R.me, to generate this content, I'm using another website called Writer. I know it's confusing, but it's a different spelling. Writer.com with a W. They have an AI content detector. And so this is really, really cool. I'm going to show you what's going to happen. So while I take this content that is 100% artificial, and I copy this, and I put it into this website, writer.com, it's going to analyze this text. It's going to tell me how AI or how human it actually is. So let's analyze it. Watch what happens. Okay, not good. What it's saying is this is only 3% human. We don't want 3%. We want like 91% or better. And that's the problem with AI content, is this is what's going to happen. So there's a couple of things you can do. Some of them are pretty obvious. One of the things I could do is I could just rewrite this. I could use AI generation just to give me ideas, and I could restructure these sentences, or I could go find a site spinner, a text spinner, or article spinner, they're called, where it just kind of rephrases these things for us and then try it that way. I found there's two things I like to do. And this software, Writer with an R, makes it really easy. First of all, it will do some rephrasing for me. So let's try that. I think it can only go so many words, but let's just take this paragraph and see if it will rephrase it for us. So I've selected the first paragraph. I'm going to click rephrase. There, it's done. Okay, so we just rephrased it a little bit, and we're going to go take this and test it again. So let's copy it. Remember, I just rephrased that top paragraph. Let's see what happens. Paste it in there, analyze it again. Look at that. Just rephrasing that first section totally changed my score from 3% all the way up to 60%, which, by the way, still not good enough, but that was a huge jump. And we have to thank Writer with an R for that, because that rephrasing was really, really realistic. What that means is when we use this program to rephrase any text we put in here, it's going to do a good job, especially since I have all these choices, like what tone I want it in, all that kind of stuff. So let's rephrase this section too. And I think you can only select up to 300 characters, and I've got 459 here. But rephrase, I have to have, about 30 to 300. So let's do this in chunks. So we'll just select from here to the end of the sentence. Let's just rephrase this part. There we go. Rephrase. That's done. And then let's take this part and go like this and rephrase. And done. Okay, now we've got this fully generated content. This is fully artificial, simply spun or rephrased artificially again. And let's see how human it actually looks. So we're going to take it into this detector, paste the whole thing in here, analyze it. See what happens. See if we can get a better score than 60 this time. Unbelievable. Just by simply rephrasing it, we've got human-generated content. I haven't even read this, by the way. I never read this. All I did was generate it, rephrase it, and now here I've got an article. I wouldn't recommend you do that. I'm just doing this for demonstration purposes. And by the way, I've done this with a lot of articles and a lot of text, and it doesn't always come out at 100%. And one of the things I've done, of course, is gone through and done some editing myself. So, for example, I go in here and I see this. I really don't want this ampersand thing in here. I want to change it to the word and. And I might go through and rephrase this stuff anyway, because it's going to go on my blog and I want it to sound right. And so you want to make sure you read it and you edit it a little bit and then run it through the content detector, AI content detector, and just make sure it stays above 91%. And you have got yourself a phenomenal content creation system. Okay, so let's try another little test here. I just asked Writer to generate some content for me on this topic, tools to see what your competitors are doing. Now, this is a very vague explanation. It would be better for me to put in more input, give it some more ideas. You've got 150 characters to do that with, which is more than enough. And it would come out even better if I had given it some keywords. But again, I'm leaving it simple just for the sake of this demonstration, because I want you to see what it does sort of in its raw form. And it generated this paragraph about competition research. So if I take this, copy this, and put it into my detector at writer.com, we're going to see that it probably doesn't come out very high. Yeah, it's only 7% human. And so again, like I just did, we want to rephrase this, right? Well, let me see what happens. I'm not sure what's going to happen because I haven't done this ahead of time. I'm just going to see how well it rephrases it. It may just do enough that we don't need to fix anything. But we're going to rephrase that. We're going to rephrase down to here. I'm selecting up to 300 characters at a time. And then let's rephrase this last one here. And again, that may be enough. So let's go like this. Copy that. Let's go see if we can get this above 7%. Analyze that. Oh, really good. 94%. That's incredible. That just speaks well of writer.me and how good it does. But if it's still not perfect, one of the things you can do is you can just take sections of this. So if this got, let's say we only scored a, 60%, what we can do is we can break this up and change it, rewrite a little bit rather than rephrase it artificially and just do it yourself, rewrite this sentence because you want to read it and you want it to fit your tone. You want it to fit your blog. And what will happen is you can just take a section of it and say, well, let's see how well this sentence does. If this is not 100%, is this sentence the problem? So I can go in here and just test this sentence and see what it's doing. If I go like this, it's going to tell me that sentence is horrible. That sentence is only 35% human. So that's why we didn't get 100%. Oh, we got 94, which is pretty good. But still, sometimes you're only going to get 50 or 60%, and that's not good. So this is how you fix it. You go, well, let's take this sentence and let's just work with that, because that is what Google's going to find. When you put this content on your website, you want to make sure that it passes the test of not getting punished by Google in your rankings. It's just way faster than writing from scratch. These AI tools are still phenomenal, but you got to make sure that you make your content human and readable and Google friendly.